All over the world, unsolved cases pile up, gathering dust among the files of local authorities. From missing persons cases to inexplicable incidents, everyone involved is usually left hunting for answers. In some of these cases, crucial moments have been captured as video footage, sending people further down the rabbit hole in search of an explanation. With that, let's take a look at some mysterious unsolved cases with video footage. Brian Schaefer. Have you ever heard the term vanished into thin air? In a case that's baffled the authorities for almost 15 years, Ohio State University medical student Brian Schaefer disappeared during a night on the town back in 2006. Around midnight on Friday, March 31st, Brian and his friends entered a bar called the Ugly Tuna Saluna, just off campus in Columbus. A short while later, Brian was spotted on CCTV chatting outside the bar before heading back inside. That was the last time anyone ever saw him. He wasn't seen leaving the bar, and despite detectives' best efforts, no trace of Brian has ever been found. What's strangest about this sudden disappearance is that this escalator entrance was the only way in or out of the building open to customers. If Brian left via the escalator that night, he would have been captured on CCTV. Alternatively, he may have used the building's service exit, but even then, he'd have been picked up on the site's cameras approaching the exit. On top of that, of all the other buildings with external CCTV in the area, not a single one captured Brian heading away from the bar. Some people believe Brian may have changed clothes and left town unnoticed for a new life somewhere else. Others suggest the cameras may have malfunctioned as Brian was leaving, or that someone doctored the footage. Or is there some other way he could have up and vanished? Let me know what you think in the comments below. The Phoenix Lights. On the evening of March 13, 1997, residents of Phoenix, Arizona looked to the skies and witnessed one of the most infamous UFO events in history. Hundreds of residents called their local law enforcement to report a series of strange lights across the sky. Witness statements differed in the details as a local UFO hotline processed calls, but ultimately, they were determined to be two separate incidents that evening. One involved a V-shaped set of moving lights seen over various parts of Phoenix, and others involved a different collection of lights hovering motionless in the sky. Here's what witnesses had to say.
It was very close to the ground. It was just like floating over the housetops.
I would gauge this object to be several football fields. I mean, like a mile, maybe more than a mile.
While some residents grabbed their tinfoil hats and prepared to welcome their new overlords, others looked to the military for answers. Although the other green men weren't exactly forthcoming. The United States Air Force initially denied any activity in the sky that evening, which spurred on rumors of a military cover-up. After being hounded by reporters, however, the Air Force eventually confirmed they'd been performing a series of exercises from the Davis-Monthan Air Force Base nearby. Military personnel explained that flares were dropped out of the back of planes as part of routine training exercises. While flares of this kind do indeed appear almost motionless in the sky, that explanation didn't fly with many Arizona residents who actively worked to debunk the flare explanation.
These lights up here represent aircraft flares. If you notice, they're not in any straight line. They vary in distance between each other. And if you look at the top, you can see the smoke. As the flare falls, it leaves a trail of smoke above it from the burning magnesium in the flare.
If you ask me, the residents' arguments against the military's flares explanation is far from compelling. But it's worth noting that, as of 2020, there's still no official explanation for the various other reports of a quickly moving V-shaped arrangement of lights. Whatever the cause, it looks like these residents really want to believe. The disappearance of Rebecca Corium. The Disney cruise ship Wonder is advertised as a place where dreams come true. But in 2011, it was more like a horrendous nightmare due to the disappearance of British 24-year-old Rebecca Corium. Rebecca was a youth activity worker aboard the cruise ship, which was traveling around the coast of Mexico from Los Angeles. Sounds like a dream job, except at 5:45 a.m. on March 22nd, she was captured on the ship's surveillance looking visibly distressed after speaking on one of the ship's internal phones. According to reports, another crew member even approached her to check if she was all right. One final shot of Rebecca shows her walking off with her hands in her pockets. These images are the only CCTV snapshots Disney have made public to date. And after those images were captured, no one saw Rebecca again. When she failed to turn up to work at 9 a.m., the crew searched the ship and the Mexican Coast Guard was alerted. Reportedly, the only trace found of Rebecca was a pair of sandals in the crew area of Deck 5. Disney later claimed Rebecca had either accidentally fallen overboard from the crew area, or she had been dragged by a freak wave into the sea. But an investigator revealed that weather patterns from that night were inconsistent with the freak wave theory. Not to mention the walls of the Deck 5 crew area were reported to be almost 6 feet high. If you look closely, you can even see they're curved inward. So how could she have accidentally fallen from this deck? Maybe it wasn't accidental at all. Many believe there's more information Disney isn't releasing. But until more is revealed, it's unlikely this mystery will get a definitive ending. The Man on the Moor. On the 12th of December 2015, a cyclist traveling along a hillside path of England's magnificent Saddleworth Moor stumbled across the body of a man whose artistry creation is shown here. He had no form of identification and no phone. Just £130 in cash, a return train ticket, and an empty medicine bottle. It appeared that he'd taken a lethal dose of strychnine, a type of poison that's illegal in the UK. With very little to go on, the police spent the next 12 months scouring CCTV footage from the surrounding areas for clues. With uncovered footage, along with DNA evidence, they eventually pieced together the man's final days. This CCTV footage traced the man, who was found to be 67-year-old David Lighton, back to Manchester's Piccadilly Station, from where he then traveled to the moor. This was intriguingly merely a few days after he'd arrived back in the UK from Pakistan, where he'd lived for the previous decade. Even though his identity was no longer a mystery, there are still unanswered questions about David's untimely death. Why had he decided to visit the moor? So far, there are no reports that claim he had any personal or historic connection to that place. So what drew him almost 2,500 miles across the world to a patch of northern England moorland? Was there a connection to his departure from Pakistan? Or perhaps a sinister reason behind his sudden relocation? Was his consumption of strychnine a personal choice, or was he forced into it? With only theories to go on, it would seem David took all those answers with him to the grave. Claudia Lawrence. On the evening of March 18, 2009, Claudia Lawrence from North Yorkshire, England, had a very normal phone call with her mother. On the phone, Claudia reportedly sounded cheerful and relaxed, but when her mother put the phone down, she had no idea it'd be the last time they'd ever speak to each other again. Claudia failed to turn up to work the next day, and despite an extensive missing persons investigation, no one has heard from her since. Police found that only Claudia's rucksack, mobile phone, and chef's whites were missing from her home, indicating she'd left for work as normal that morning. Authorities later released CCTV footage of the road next to Claudia's home from the evening of her disappearance, highlighting a suspicious figure in the case. A lone man clad in black can be seen moving behind Claudia's house at 7:15 p.m. 1 minute later, he reemerges carrying what looks like a bag over his shoulder. Even more suspicious is that he pauses in the street when he notices another person walking past the end of the road. He only proceeds when the coast is clear. Was he trying to avoid being noticed? Was he scoping out Claudia's home? Despite a police call out to identify the man, no one has ever come forward. The case has gone cold, and for now at least, Claudia seems to have disappeared without a trace. Jackie Sutton. Tragedy makes it into international headlines more often than not, but very few headline stories are as bizarre as Jackie Sutton's. An international reporter, Sutton was traveling from Istanbul to Iraq for work back in 2015. Security footage from October 17th shows her calmly making her way through Ataturk Airport before her flight to Erbil. However, Sutton missed her flight and was advised to purchase another ticket. According to her friend, she was an experienced traveler, and her company would have covered the cost, so rebooking shouldn't have been too stressful. But no one could have predicted what was about to happen. After learning she'd missed her flight, Sutton entered a nearby restroom out of the scope of the surveillance cameras. She was found 7 minutes later, apparently having taken her own life in one of the cubicles. While it was undoubtedly tragic, not everyone believed that simply missing a flight triggered Jackie's reaction. The supposed sudden snap in her behavior didn't add up for some, as just hours before she was captured on camera having bought bottles of wine to give to a friend in Iraq. If she wasn't planning on delivering them, why purchase them? It left many seeking answers and claiming her death was a potential cover-up, or even premeditated in response to Jackie's effort to promote a free press in the Middle East. An official inquest in 2016 concluded she'd committed the act impulsively, without any prior reason, possibly due to the stress of both her job and missing her flight. But for those who remain unconvinced, Jackie's sudden actions are a hot topic to this day. Worldwide hum. Have you ever been out in nature or even just in your yard at home and heard an incredibly loud sound like enormous pieces of metal grinding together in the distance? If so, you're not alone. This phenomenon, known as the hum, comes from a series of widespread reports of an occasional, unexplainable noise heard by people the world over. On the internet, videos are constantly springing up of supposed recordings of this phenomena. But whatever it is, it sends a shiver down my spine. Here's one from British Columbia back in 2018. These bizarre noises have been likened to colossal trumpets thundering down from above. Some passionate commenters even believe these sounds are angelic trumpeters signaling Armageddon. But let's put our tinfoil hats down for a moment and listen to another example recorded in Alberta, Canada. A similar phenomenon was apparently heard over the city of Jerusalem in 2016, accompanied by a perfectly circular cloud. Of course, these videos need to be taken with a pinch of salt, as sounds like these could easily be added over the videos. Plus, the movement of the clouds over Jerusalem looks suspiciously like a video loop edited into the scene. In fact, the Jerusalem video is almost certainly edited, being first uploaded by special effects artist Rodden Bahrani, though he's since deleted it from his YouTube channel. That doesn't mean the phenomenon isn't real. Historic instances of the hum have been recorded as far back as 1828, when a traveler and his party in the Pyrenees Mountains all heard an overwhelmingly loud moaning sound reverberating around them. But more recently, scientific studies have shown that some people experience auditory sensations of this kind when radio frequency energy interacts with the inner components of their ears. This is occasionally experienced by people working at microwave transmitting sites as a buzzing or rumbling sound. But of course, a sound generated in someone's head wouldn't be picked up by a camera's microphone. So could the sounds in the more convincing videos be something else, like the movements of giant underground glaciers, as some theorize? Or are these videos all just an elaborate multi-person hoax? You decide. Disappearance of Lars Metank. This is Lars Metank, a then 28-year-old from Itzehoe, northern Germany. Shortly before he was due to catch his flight home from a vacation in Bulgaria in 2014, he was captured on CCTV making his way through Varna Airport. He appears fine, but only a few minutes later, Lars can be seen bolting out of the terminal without explanation. He'd abandoned all his belongings, including his passport, wallet, and phone, and never returned. This troubling footage was the last time he was seen, but what could have spooked him so badly? According to his friends, Lars was injured one evening after getting into a fight at a bar, leaving him with a perforated eardrum and possible concussion. A doctor advised him to delay flying home to prevent cabin pressure worsening the injury. But after checking into a cheap hostel that evening, Lars began acting strange. He rang his mother and told her there were people trying to rob him, or maybe worse, and then asked her to cancel his bank cards. The next day, the airport doctor he was required to get an all clear from described his behavior as erratic. He even heard him say, "I don't want to die here, I have to get out of here," before he fled. It's possible that his head trauma may have triggered feelings of paranoia and disorientation, or possibly even a psychotic breakdown, though no formal diagnosis has been possible. More than half a decade on, Lars's whereabouts remain unknown. What are your suspicions about these cases? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching.